Hey, my name is Dave Watkins, and I'm a designer, an illustrator, and a YouTuber. I've been using Adobe Illustrator for well over 15 years, and in that time, I've constantly been looking for new tools and techniques to add to my creative arsenal to make me a more efficient designer. Time and time again, I've run into situations where modifying an existing path can be quite tedious and cumbersome, and it's actually easier to create a new path from scratch. Situations like this can pop up because you've received feedback well after the point where you've outlined strokes or even merged elements together using the Pathfinder. Today, I'm going to introduce you to a tool from Astute Graphics that will make a fantastic addition to your workflow in situations like this. The feature itself is called the Reform Tool, and it does exactly what its name implies. It allows you to take an existing path and reform or modify it to get to a spot where you're happy with it. Using traditional tools and techniques, you can achieve the same result, but it might take you significantly more time to get there. So speaking of time, let's not waste any more here. Let's go jump into Illustrator and get this demo started. Here we are in Illustrator, and we're having a look at a crest that I built for this demonstration today. And while I'm really happy with the way it turned out, there are several areas inside of this graphic that could definitely use some adjustment. For instance, the stripes on the nose and the snout could be much thicker, much heavier. Right now, they're far too thin compared to other areas in the graphic. And I think with some finesse, this graphic will look much stronger. If we switch over to outline mode, you'll see that there's no strokes here. These are all filled paths, and everything has been condensed together with the Pathfinder. So modifying these can be a little bit cumbersome, a little bit tedious. We'll deal with some traditional methods for changing this up in the next section. So let's take a look at these stripes on the tiger's nose, and let's see what we can do to bulk these up a little bit. Traditionally, what I would have done was one of two things. I would have used the direct selection tool and the pen tool to adjust the points that make up this path to make them appear thicker. So I'd move around with the direct selection tool, find points that I could move, handles that needed adjusting, and then I would also use the pen tool to remove extra points. So in this case, there's a couple in here, so I might remove that one. I would use key commands along the way to switch back and forth between tools, and then I would convert anchor points to bring out a fresh set of handles. And I would sit here and try to manipulate these areas to get a result that I was happy with. And this can take a fair amount of time. And if you're dealing with one small section, you may have that time to spare. But there was a whole number of areas that I wanted to do this to, so I definitely like to work faster. And like I said in the intro, one of the ways that I would do that was to just create a whole new section of path and merge that back in with the Pathfinder. So to do that, I would have used the pen tool. I'd find a section that I could tie into, and I would literally redraw a section from scratch that I would be using as a patch to add to the original path. So in a lot of ways, this seems faster than adjusting the original path, but it still is a tedious process because here I've built it, then I'm going to need to use the selection tools to pick up both of these paths, and then I'm going to use the Pathfinder to merge it all together. And the results are definitely not as clean as my original that was created with a single item and a blend. They've ended up looking a little bit rougher than what I had gone for in the first place. So there's traditionally how I might have adjusted some paths. Now I'm going to show you the Reform tool. So let's compare apples to apples and work on the same section of the graphic with the Reform tool. Now you saw me manipulate these areas with the pen tool, the direct selection tool. The Reform tool, once you have it installed, can be found down here. For me personally, I like to keep it docked over here. And when you click on it and you see this palette pop up, you'll need to click on the palette to make the Reform tool active. Now, with a lot of other editing tools inside of Illustrator, you need to select a path before you can start to work on it. The Reform tool allows you to hover over multiple paths that don't need to be selected, and a blue outline is going to pop up to show you that that's the area that you're going to reform once you click your mouse. So to start with, we're going to use the sculpt option with the reform tool, which just means you need to click to add one of these sculpting points, and then you can drag it either in or out. And the red line that appears is a preview of the transformation that's going to take place. And you could add multiple points along this path, along the preview. And basically, you just ignore the existing construction of the path, and the reform tool does all of the work for you. There was multiple points along here. I've just added in two of these sculpting points, and we can make one thicker, we can make one thinner, and all of this work is being done for us. Once we hit enter, the result applies and the path has been thickened up with just those two clicks and drags. So I'll undo that, and you can see just how quickly I'm able to repeat that process. One click, two clicks, enter. And we have a much thicker path, which is the result that we're going for. One thing you'll want to be aware of is if you're really dramatic with the sculpting, if you come too far in on an inside corner like this, you'll end up with an area that kind of intersects with itself. And that's not an effect that we like. If you turn on the clipping option within the reform tool palette, this whole section will now be cleanly clipped. So you end up with a sharp corner point there. Hit enter and you're good to go. So the first couple examples that I showed you with the reform tool, I just clicked and selected the first sections that popped up here. And by default, the reform tool will give you a corner point from end to end. And I was content with that for these sections here, to just add in one or two sculpt points and to work from a corner point to a corner point. But I think a really powerful feature of this reform tool is the ability to start a sculpt and then midway through adjust the endpoints. So right now this went from corner point to corner point, but if we wanted to come around the corner, we can adjust this endpoint on the fly and start adding sculpting points up here because we wanted to maybe thicken up this section a bit. And then we can come back to the original point that we added and we can thin that down. And this red line gives us this preview. So the whole time as we're working on this section, we get this real-time preview of what's going to take place once we apply this reform. And really, you can get quite creative and sculpt a path without needing to adjust all those underlying points underneath it. So let's get to a spot where we're happy with this, hit enter, and that result is pretty cool. So for this next section, I'm going to speed up the video a little bit as I work my way around the tiger with the reform tool. And here I am adding all of this extra bulk to the graphic, where traditional methods would have taken a significantly longer amount of time. I'm able to work on the fly and see the preview of the sections as I'm working on them. And with one or two clicks at a time, I'm able to make very large adjustments to the original paths. Now, this is a symmetrical graphic, so I'm only working on the left-hand side. Once I'm done manipulating everything, I'm going to grab it here quickly and use the Mirror Me plugin, also from Astute Graphics, to create a quick reflection. Okay, now I'm quickly going to show you a couple options up here at the top of the crest using the reform tool. Everything that we've done up until now has been using the sculpt option. So if you hover over a section here, you can see three options in your Astute Buddy. A single click is going to create a sculpt point, which you could then manipulate. And then there's two other options. There's the option click, and then there's the shift option click. An option click is going to give you a looped offset, which will be handy for crests like this, where you've outlined the stroke, but you still want to be able to manipulate either the inner or outer radius of that stroke. So by option clicking and dragging, we can get a result like this. And that traditionally would have been a fair amount of work because you would have had to have released the compound path, use the offset function to offset it, and then you would have had to use the pathfinder to resubtract it from the compound path. The final option that we'll deal with here is a shift option click, and that's going to give us a constant offset. So we get endpoints, it's not the full loop, and you can offset just the full section like this, and it doesn't tuck back into the endpoints, it fully extends the same distance all the way across the path. The one option that you want to be aware of with this kind of reform is the smart rejoin. There would have been a void that was created here, but by using the smart rejoin, it closes that off and you end up with a result that looks like this once you hit enter. So that's a really neat feature of the reform tool. So here's the final example that I'm going to leave you with today for the reform tool. Up until this point, all of the paths that I've modified have been quite clean. They've been created with the pen tool and shape tools and weren't all that organic looking. That being said, the reform tool still handles itself well on a path that is a little bit rough, like this example here. The tiger crest has been run through a roughen filter, and you can achieve this result with maybe an auto trace piece of artwork that came from a traditional pencil sketch or something that was modified with art brushes. That being said, the only thing you're going to need to be aware of are these end handles. There's more likely to be corner points throughout your artwork, so you may need to adjust these a little bit more often. But once you do, the sculpting with one handle here is going to apply itself to all of these points along the path, and it's still going to maintain the organic looking nature of the artwork, which I think is a tremendous time saver.